Watch out. Our galaxy, the Milky Way, and the Andromeda Galaxy are on a collision course. In 3.75 billion years, the night sky from Earth will look like this. Yeah, but don't be too scared because one, you will be dead long before they collide. And also, galaxies are mainly empty space, so Earth is probably not gonna collide with any other planets or stars, but our solar system will be dragged around and tugged by all that new matter. Here is a NASA simulation at much faster than real-time speed of what it will look like when our galaxies collide. Whew, it's gonna be fun. You probably won't be alive for it, but you can track this cosmic collision in real time at howfarawayisandromeda.neocities.org. Yeah, this website allows you to watch for free on the internet just how much closer Andromeda is every second. Doing something like that, by the way, is a choice dong. Something you can do online now, guys. The Andromeda Galaxy is about 2.5 million light years away from Earth right now. Every star in our own galaxy is much closer. And if a star is as many light years away from Earth as you are years old, well, that will mean that when you look at that star right now, you will be seeing light that left that star's surface at about the same time that you left your mother. I've shared a site in the past where you could enter your birth date and have the website find a star that is as far away in space as you are old in time, but I found a new one that I like a bit better, Birthday Star. Now with Playback.fm, you can enter your birthday and see what the number one song or movie was the day you were born. Click, 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 dot, click narrates what you are doing in a calming, creepy voice.
We are entering a more passive phase.
Now, there's no way to win or lose, but if you're lonely and want to feel like you're being watched, it's great. If you prefer jump scares over creepiness, try where'sthejump.com. This dong only lists movies that scored at least a 4 out of 5 for jump scare frequency. You'll see the name of the movie, who directed it, the year it was made, its jump score rating, and its number of jump scares. If you're in the mood to be spooked, you should watch The Haunting in Connecticut 2, Ghosts of Georgia. But for something less scary, try a platformer for ants. The controls are just the arrow keys and spacebar. Every time you enter a new room, the game zooms out to fit in every room you've visited. As you discover more of the dungeon, your character appears smaller and smaller. On Cellular Tones, you can click and drag around to see cool formations and also hear unpleasant sounds. Now, that's how it sounds on some browsers. On Chrome, it sounds a little better. But darn it, I need to enter a new password. Well, I'll just enter it here. Oh, well, that's rude. I'll try it again. Wow, well, passive-aggressive password is not being very encouraging. Finally, big shout out to Audible for sponsoring this episode. It's no secret that I love books, but audiobooks, oh, that is like candy for your ears and your brain, and in a way, for your soul and for our species. Now, if you go to audible.com/doonline, you can get a free audiobook with a 30-day trial. I have a recommendation for you. I just finished, on my flight here to Hawaii, The Three-Body Problem, the first book in a science fiction trilogy that blew my mind. I mean, in a kind of a scary way. It's some of the hardest sci-fi I have ever read. It's all about, well, I shouldn't say too much, but it is incredible. They're making it into a movie. If anyone working on the movie wants me involved, just give me a little ring. I'd love to be a part of it because the book is incredible. You can get the audiobook for The Three-Body Problem on audible.com. Going to audible.com/doonline means that you can get an audiobook for free with a 30-day trial. Audible has a great collection of comedy, news, books, you name it, they've got it. Thanks for supporting this episode, Audible, and as always, thanks for watching.